Welcome everyone. In this video lecture, we will solve a op-amp and Zener diode based gate question. Okay, so basically in this question, we have to find the regulated power or regulated DC output voltage, that is this voltage, say this one is a V naught. For this question, we have given a 15 volt DC unregulated power source that may be vary from 0 to 15 volt. So we have to find the V naught voltage. So here you can see that there is a Zener diode. Okay, so there is a Zener diode and we are giving one input, is this one inverting input. Okay, inverting input and non-inverting terminal. So if there is a Zener diode, so the voltage across the inverting input should be 3 volt. So this voltage is nothing but 3 volt, and due to virtual ground concept, the same voltage will appear across the non-inverting terminal. Say this one is also becomes 3 volt. So this one is the beauty of this question, means how to solve. So this 3 volt equals to this 3 volt. Okay, because this Zener diode, it's a voltage regulator circuit that will fix a constant DC voltage in a circuit even if we change the regulated power supply. Okay, so we can see that this voltage is 3 volt, so we have to find this V naught. So in general we can do like that. This one is our 40 kilo ohm and this resistance is 20 kilo ohm, and this one is say some voltage, say regulated DC output voltage, and we have given this voltage is 3 volt. Is it okay or not? Means once again I am repeating, due to this VZ, okay, 3 volt, okay, the regulated voltage at the inverting end is 3 volt. So now again due to virtual ground concept, this voltage at this point also it should be 3 volt. Okay, after that this one is 3 volt, so next we have to make this resistance as a 40 ohm and 20 ohm this one, and this voltage we know this one is 3 volt, so we have to find V naught. So what we have to do, we have to just apply the voltage division rule. Okay, or for example, suppose this, for example I am writing this one, say this one is R1 and R2, and say this voltage is a V output and this voltage is a V in. Okay, so one can write V output equals to opposite resistance into V in by R1 plus R2. Is it okay? This is concept. Very important concept is this one. Means if there is one resistance here, okay, input voltage is there, output voltage is there. So the output voltage R2, simple KVL KCL, Kirchhoff's law you have to apply. So again, we can write the directly the output for the time being. If we say this one is our V1 or anything, so we can write V1 equals to, and take this V naught as a input side, we can say, so it should be V naught into V1 equals to V naught into 20 kilo by 20 kilo plus 40 kilo ohm. So we can write V1 is given 3 volt. Okay, so V naught, so here we can write 20 by 60, means kilo ohm should be cancelled out, so it should be 1 by 3. So from here we can say this V naught equals to 9 volt. So the our answer should be 9 volt. So this one is the simple question. Okay, means how to find the output DC voltage. So this one is the concept. Okay, so once again I am repeating the basic. This one is our unregulated power source, okay, in which it may vary from 0 to 15. Okay, even if we change, this voltage will be fixed to 3 volt due to this Jenner diode, and this inverting input voltage become 3 volt. Now due to the virtual ground concept, the non-inverting voltage will also become 3 volt. So now this way 20 kilo ohm resistance, 40 kilo ohm resistance, and this voltage is 3 volt. So we can easily find the V naught by using this concept. Okay, basically this one is the concept, means voltage, how voltage division rule. Okay, so from directly we can say the V naught value equals to 3 volt. V naught equals to 9 volt after solving. So this is all about the simple problem with op-amp and Jenner diode based. Okay, so you have to utilize simple Kirchhoff's law concept for this one. So thank you for watching.